Well, you asked for it, more League of Legends coverage by me. Here we are. This is round two of Fragosity. I did not get the first match going on, but we've got our team Bootleg Fireworks versus I just want to say Moe's team. I don't know his name, but I'll include that in the title. And the counterpicking was just so hilariously good in this. Ezreal over here just fucking hard counterpicked himself for no good reason. Oh, and the new replay client looks so good. Holy shit, yeah. So we've got everybody buying their shit. Going and doing their stuff. The Taric Graves combo bottom was probably the best thing that we got. And everybody's like, oh, you know, go do this. What Jamie here, Dark Google X, is telling me to do is to put a ward right here in the bush because we think they're going to invade. So... I haven't seen what they're doing or what they tried to do. Okay, so they're protecting theirs and we're protecting ours, so there's no real exciting early game going on here. So they could have possibly invaded it red. Who knows? All I know is we had some good coverage going on right here. Man, oh man, hold on, let me turn off the... Let me turn down the master volume here, just so the commentary is a little bit more fluid. Okay then. So now we're all heading bottom lane. Make sure Mumu's okay. Make sure they don't invade. And they very well could have. They could have just fucking slaughtered us if they would have done that. Probably would have been a winning game. Who knows? I'm not digging this 30 frames per second bullshit. Hold on. Oh well. Not really much to say here. Now I will tell you they did we did get pretty dominated hard early game. That was pretty hilarious. Let's look at top here. Gotta love that Cho'Gath skin. Sammy Jones, whoever you are, I love Battlecast Prime Cho'Gath. He's awesome. Nice dodge there, Wukong. Can't last hit to save your life, but we still love you anyways. Oh, very nice. There he goes, countering here at bottom. Got a Mumu early ganking at level 2, so we have a little bit of an advantage here. They're going to ask me to go in on Ezreal if they ping here in a little bit. So they see a Mumu and they're like, oh, run away, so I stun him. And a failed gank. Oh well. That's cool too. That's just fine. Everything's fine. And I take that opportunity to ward. Meanwhile in mid. Got Zyra over here, being all cool and shit. Interesting choice for a silent killer right here, because he usually plays junglers in top. I've never really seen him play mid before. If you remember, he was on my Fragosity team last year when he was playing. I don't remember. At any rate, Cho'Gath's currently winning this lane, pushing him forward. He could have used the gank more than I had, more than we could have at bottom, really. Nice counter-aggression there, Wukong. I'm trying to figure out what exactly he had trouble with. Because he did have a lot of trouble in this thing. Oh, that's what happened. He got the ignite off. And Cho'Gath tower dove, but... Okay, that's a one for one. little too aggressive. Oh, back here at bottom we got... Good thing I warded there. Good thing we saw that coming. Because we might just have gotten ourselves killed. Love this Beast Snake, dude. He's really good. AD carry. It was really fun to support. Josh, if you're watching this, man, I love you. Alright, and there's the bush ward. Cool stuff. You might remember Jakur as well. He was on my team last year as a mid. He was playing Ziggs mid, and he did pretty well for himself. He's doing really well as support. I'm actually impressed and a bit surprised at the least. Chopsy the jungler coming down here to try to gank us. But we see it, and we're like, nope! Can't have it. You just can't have it. Really good jungling, though. The first round they played, they actually really just rolled some face. I was pretty impressed. And Zyra's like, nope, you're not getting me. Meanwhile, up here at top. Now, for some reason, Wukong is pushing. Now, Cape, if you're watching this, you are pushing too hard as of now. To make your lane gankable... Okay, well, I mean, there you go. But to make your lane gankable, you want to draw a line, like, right here, and just stay behind that line. You know, using the torch to the wall. But, at any rate... Nice gank by stick people, but... Unfortunately, Chopsy comes in here and gets the counter. Or does Amumu get away? Because if he does, that's hilarious. Oh. Okay, that's interesting. Is he going to get... Nope. Oh, quite a passive early game. We've only got just a slight gold advantage from the two kills, and I'm not sure why. I think these guys on their team are running gold quints or something. I mean, they have to be. This Faerul guy over here, the first round, I'm just going to tell you now, he dominated really hard as Ezreal. Not as Ezreal, but as Tristana. He just, oh god, he went 13-1 or something like that. And just won the game at about 30-45 minutes in. It was pretty crazy. He got a bunch of doubles and triple kills. Is Beastsnake here leading in the farm? No, it's Ezreal. He's leading in last hit, as you can see down there. But you know, Beastsnake here is a really good AD carry, but Faerul is just far better. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. Faerul, whatever. Faerul, like Will Faerul. Like, whatever. And Chopsy with the fail gank because Ward. What you could have done, Chopsy, is gotten a Oracle's Elixir at this point. Like, I guess I know you're rushing Madred's Blood Razors here, but I don't know. Like, instead of cloth armor, you could have sold your two potions and gotten Oracles and gotten some free gold out of that and free ganks. That would have really screwed us over, actually. And there's pinging down here going on for some reason. I'm not sure why. Wukong is currently 0-2, and I'm not sure why. But Mumu over here is going to babysit bottom lane. And you're being a little too aggressive there, stick people. Stick to the tower and farm. Because, I mean, even if you would have stunned Cho'Gath, you would have eventually just, like, you wouldn't have gotten it. It's poking Cho'Gath, there's no point to it. See, like, I mean, even here he's just going to escape under his tower. But, oh well, I guess you're forcing him out of lane and denying him some gold, so that's pretty nice. Speaking of denying, over here, if you look at the mid lane, LeBlanc is only one ahead of Zyra. I remember hearing him talking after the match that he got denied pretty hard for some reason. I'm not sure how that happened. Stick people here. Could have counter jungled at this point instead of trying to gank mid. I guess he's waiting for him to push. See if something happens. Oh, here we go. There we go. Very nice escape by LeBlanc. They got the ignite off, but it just wasn't quite enough. Oh, well. So they're pushing the tower there. And Chopsy just doesn't give a fuck. He's going to go in and do some stuff. I'm being really careful not to use everyone's actual name. It's really tempting. because I know some people just simply don't want to be identified. Very nice by Wukong there. Just remember to hug the tower a little more, I guess. I don't know. Moomoo ganking from the tri-bush. It's not warded, so... But I guess Cho'Gath gets a little... His spider senses start tingling. Or whatever. And here comes Chopsy for the counter gank. And here comes Dark Google for the counter gank. Who knows what's actually going to happen. Well, I know what's happening, but... Most of the people who played this match knows what's happening. Back down here. Not a lot of things going on, just passive farming. The real exciting, like we're 10 minutes in and we're just 2-2. And they've got a much better gold advantage than us. They have to be running gold quints. I'm going to have to ask them later if they actually did. Oh, cool stuff anyway. Siren Kira. Doing really good on last hits. Zyra's just one ahead so far. Wukong up here does not have a lot of last hits compared to Cho'Gath, so that's what's really screwing us over in gold. So maybe they aren't running gold quints, they're just a whole lot better at last hitting than us, which, well, I totally understand. Oh, and Chop's trying to counter jungle, which... Was it? Yeah, that was successful by Silent Killer. Nice blue grab there. I'm going to go in here and try to get a Moomoo while Wukong tries to come down, and Dark Google's going to circle in on them. Who knows what's going to happen? Oh, nice snare. Very nice ult. And Chopsy gets away. Oh, well. Don't chase. Don't chase. Bad idea. Ah. We're losing out on last hits in this lane, but we're pushing it pretty hard because we got the poke. It's too bad that they had Soraka because... It kept denying us a lot of kills because of her wish and her heals and things like that. Graves over here not giving a fuck. He's just like, man, screw you, Ezreal. I don't like no faggoty little explorer boy. That's a terrible accent. I need to stop doing that. Wukong. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I guess you're doing fine right now. Nice ult out of that. I don't know, it's just like, I guess if you're playing solo top, it's just best to hug the tower as much as possible in an attempt to let the jungler get an early gank. It'll help you out more in the long run, and it really will result in more last hits if the enemy laning partner's dead. Very nice. Is there a way I can rewind that? I guess so. Let's go back a few seconds and see how he got killed exactly. Like, I just want to see what mistakes he made. Alright, what he was doing is, okay, so he escapes into the tower, but I'm not sure how he dies. He goes in on him like that, which he shouldn't have done, because Cho'Gath got he got his R on him, and he got the ignite. I mean, he was a goner for sure. You should have kept track of that. But it's whatever. We're still not that far behind in gold, but it appears that we're going to lose the game by now, but I don't know. I guess you'll see what happens. And I ping there to tell them, oh, Chopsy's up there, because he's a blue. And LeBlanc, last hitting like a champion. Zyra's doing pretty well for herself. So we just kind of hugged the tower. I went back as well to get a... What do I have in terms of gold? I've got 642 at this point, so I think I go back and buy some boots. Very nice kill by Wukong there. We were joking about it, actually. After he got that kill, we were like, yeah, new meta. Feed top and then shut down. Obviously, that's a very cruel and unfunny joke. Good warding. That's what you're doing right. That's fine. doing great there. And Chopsy's all, yeah, let's go kill him. Oh man. And he escapes. And hold on, let me pause this. Let me turn down the shadows. Let me just or just something. Okay, effects quality's fine, but frame rate cap. Let's put it at 60 and turn shadows off. And let's see if that's any better. Okay, not by much. I don't like that. Oh, we can do that. Okay. Yeah, let me do this real fast. That's fine. I prefer at least a low shadow to no shadow. Alright. Continue. See how much of a difference it makes with the shadows? It just looks so... It just looks really good. I don't know. That's my opinion. Like, I noticed a lot of people were there on their laptops and they have shadows disabled. And it makes their frame rate really nice. So, that's something to consider. Nice snare there by Zyra. Poking and forcing him to go back a little bit. Bad Wukong. Again, you're pushing too hard. Way too hard. Nice ult escape, but, you know, it may not have been enough. Oh, we've got some crazy shit going down on here. Me and Mumu and Graves decide to try to get early dragon. Meanwhile, Chopsy up here is going to try to gank Zyra. Very nice pushback, but very nice snare as well. Good wall flash. That's going to give us a little bit of a gold advantage there, 16.8. So... You can see now how much gold advantage really does matter. Slaying the dragon does a whole lot, and holy crap, everybody's coming bottom. I think this is where we get a little bit screwed over. Because me and Graves over here are 0, 0, and 0. We're the only ones that haven't really done anything. Alright. Oh, and here's something going on mid. Not entirely sure what's happening. Blah blah blah. Sorry if I don't really have much to say. It's really passive so far, so I can't really be Korean shoutcaster as of now. Oh shit. Dark Google, you okay? You okay over there, buddy? Yushima, shit. Ethan's gonna try to cave. He's gonna try to tower dive. Yeah, and that's gone. Very nice kill. Let's go back and see how that happened. Okay, so I got flashed in, got the stun. Graves got the W off. He got the ult and the Q off. Very nice there by stick people. And I'm just taking tower hits like a man because I'm Taric and I don't give a fuck. I really should have taken oracles, but wards are more important. Oh lord. Yes. For future reference, if you are a Wukong player, please do not push top so hard. Oh well, I mean, he had a positive attitude throughout the entire match, so it doesn't really matter to me. There you go, hug the tower, keep it protected. We're over here just not caring because it's Soraka, and she's like, oh no, a little silence. Really good Soraka, though, like, holy shit. Getting your Ezreal fed like that, I mean, he's already got his best friend sword. BF sword, hell yeah. I love this shit. I really like this new LoL replay interface, like, it actually makes sense now. It's really cool. I prefer it to the old one. Cho'Gath's going into jungle Cho'Gath mode now, sharing the jungle with Hecarim. Dark Google in mid, still farming, still not a lot going on. Wukong's farming as well. Perhaps to bait and distract them, but it's not going to be enough. I don't know. I don't even know what I'm saying. Oh man, very nice. Got the turret kill. Oh shit. And a Mumu is about to die. Oh, never mind. I mean, he seems tanky enough. Yeah, we decided on taking a lot of early magic resistance. We're like, yeah, go ahead and get a Negatron cloak. You know, just become an all-around tank because we don't like LeBlanc. Early LeBlanc is nasty, just sick nasty. Waiting on that ward to clear so he can set a new one. Chops are coming down to gank it. Pretty much the perfect time. Anamumu. We're all wondering what to do at this point. Dark Google was going to come bot, but it appears we didn't need too much help with that. Oh, and a big mistake by Stick People going in too far. So, alright, we're all trying to assess this team fight, and not a lot's happening. There's the free kill for Chopsy. I don't know why he flashed, but he could have gotten it anyways. Might have died there. I did all I could trying to heal and everything. I don't know why you're still laning, Wukong. I mean, farming is important, but you could have come and helped us bottom. Would have been really nice. Because once your tower's gone, there's really no point in staying in lane. But I'm being too hard on you. I love you, Wukong. I love you. You're still my nigga for life. And Chopsy's counter jungling very nicely. Man, he knows his shit. Zyra's about to just fucking get pounced on. Very nice save by Mumu. Coming in for the stun. The double stun, in fact. We almost got Soraka, but we didn't. Good kill. Very nice ult by Ezreal. LeBlanc's going to try to come in and kill Beast Snake. And what happened there was, I was like, I think I'd rather die than you. Because you have a kill and I don't. So they'll get less gold for me. So, not a very good team fight, but we did what we could. Wukong, what are you doing? You don't need to push that tower. Alright then. Blue-red Zyra. I like this. I like this a whole lot. Yeah, that's really cool. Look at Amumu missing his grab. Oh well. Not too much. Still kind of an uneventful game, but, you know, I'd rather show it in its full length than cut some of the content. Because, I mean, you can see in the bar here, it's a 57-minute long game. And I'm sure a lot of you really want to analyze and break down every little single bit. So I'll let you do that. Very nice. Good move here by getting Dragon while we're all distracted. I think my favorite two people from the enemy team are Chopsy and Feyrule, and Silent Killer, of course, because they really seem to understand the game and on a whole other level, more so than I do. The Oracle's ward there is just a little bit off. They could have been like, you know, right around here or something. Could have gotten our ward. Got another 25 gold on us, but it's all good. But I know, that's just how I ward. Like, I intentionally do that so when someone wards dragon, they can't see my sight ward. Oh well. Dracor here is doing really well too. I'm liking that Soraka. Soraka wins team fights, man, especially if the enemy team doesn't have a Karthus. Very nice tower. Okay. I guess there was a point to you pushing the lane. Well, you're 2-3-1, so that's not too terribly bad. Good poke by Graves. Pro Graves bait. We just got wards everywhere a map. It's litting up like a damn light bright from the 70s, man. Wait, was that from the 70s? I don't know. Don't quote me on that. Fey Rule, the champion of last hitting. Jesus, 180 CS. Oh man. Graves is just only 5 behind now. So, I don't know. Guess that's the difference that about 1,000-something games makes. God, this is a really strong team. Honestly, before we faced them, we got to watch a match that they played, so that did give us a little bit of an advantage against them, like, because we looked at their aggressive play style and we assessed how they did ganks and things like that. We looked where they warded and things, so I guess that kind of gave us a little bit of an edge, but still, we're losing 5-8. It's not looking too good, but we still remain optimistic because we're CLG. We turtle pretty hard. You'll see that a little bit later. Graves over here, being awesome. Pro deep warding. They're all thinking that someone's gonna come from here, apparently. Oh, he's like Oracle's ward. Okay, I see. Chopsy, blah blah blah. Don't know why they're pinging there. I don't really know. Yeah, at this point we're like push mid because it needs to be pushed. Mid or nothing. Mumu here is trying to bait them into a team fight so we can I think his ult is up at this point, I'm not sure. It doesn't show in this LOL replay thingy. Let me click on a Moomoo, see if there's anything cooling down here. Oh yeah, because I have Fraps running, the whole cooldown timer is disabled, so that's not gonna work. Dang, 524 damage, a hit from Ezreal, that's sick nasty, man. What does he have? What is this? Started with a damn... Oh yeah, he's got Infinity Edge, no wonder. I apparently heard he started with a Brutalizer, but and he was complaining that it wasn't doing enough damage against Graves. Because what happened... Oh, I'll explain that later. Hold on. Teamfight's about to break out. Oh, very nice. Zyra ult. Here we go. Everybody gets the knockup. Nice kill by Beast Snake there. I was going to try to flash in and stun. Ethan pushing a little too hard, but he gets a double kill out of it anyways. Oh, and very nice probate. Okay, that was good. I lied. Dark Google just nearly escaping death. Very good team fight. And now we're leading in... No, we're not leading in gold. We're still 1K behind. Man. Crazy shit. They're leading both in kills and turret kills. That farm in Graves. Now Graves is ahead in CS, which makes me very happy. Sammy with the jungle. Wukong farming so he can get a little bit caught up there. Got more farm than mid. It's pretty good. Quite insane. Right. Mumu's got the Banshee's Veil now, so they can't burst his bubble. Don't you love my cheesy humor? It's terrible. I am probably the whitest guy imaginable when it comes to that kind of thing. I love the team comp we have going on here, though. We've got Amumu's ult, we've got Zyra's ult, which are both long, well, moderately long stuns. We've got my Taric's E, which dazzle, very nice. I don't think Graves or Wukong stun any. Maybe a better solo top would have been something like Poppy, or maybe even... He was debating going Kennen solo top against Cho'Gath, actually. But we decided to that he should do Wukong for some crazy reason. Good Dragon Slay there. Get a further lead in gold. And do I see a team fight? Yep. There's two wards right on top of one another. Very nice shutdown there. We got the double ult thing going on. But I think, unfortunately, we're going to lose this team fight. Yeah, Graves is about to get ripped a new one. Oh, LeBlanc. Ah, get out of there, Mumu. What are you doing? Okay, good. Zyra's just defending the tower with her life. And her saplings. Whatever they're called. I call them saplings because Magic the Gathering. Or sapperling or whatever the fuck. I don't care about semantics, really. A lot of people get really anal about it, but I'm just like, eh, whatever. Graves and Ezreal are having a CS battle right now. Graves got Trinity Force. That's the pro build right there because, yeah, Riot advice. That's how you do it. That's how you do it, man. That's how you do it! Okay, so they're all like, let's go around this way. I guess, okay, Oracle's ward there. Good support by Soraka. I am thoroughly impressed if you're watching this, Dracor. Very nice. And at this point, we're just pushing mid, not letting them get that mid tower. Because we don't want that to happen. That's the last thing we want to happen. They're defending theirs as well. Big stompy Cho'Gath. Gotta love it. He just looks so happy in his element. He's like, hey, 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 hey. And he wards there. Good ward by him. That Hecarim's really spooky. I like all the skins they had, actually. Oh, good ult. Very nice start to a team fight. Ezreal gets the Mumu kill. Not very good at talking really fast, so I'm just gonna slowly analyze it. Like, I'm not really a Korean shoutcaster, you know, I don't go, I just, that's what's going on and tell it. Just seems more sensible that way. And good tower kill, there we go, we can engage in another team fight. Nice escape bait by Wukong. Shut down. It's all good. So we're starting to catch up. But we're still 3k behind. Or just under 3k behind. And, do I ever go get an Oracle's Elixir? Because that would have really helped us if I would have done that. Jungle Graves just being a pro. And at this point I think they think we're doing Baron. So I guess they're warding or something? I don't know. He's sitting there to make sure. Alright. I never got to see this side. And they're like, nope, we're not doing Baron. So we're just gonna go roam around a little bit more. And me and Zyra are going to come up here. Keep the pressure on middle. And we see that they're doing Baron, so we were a little bit scared when we saw that. We were like, oh shit, that's game. So we all come in here. And Baron generated all his health. Good god. And now that they're all out of there, I think we all decide to get... Do we go get Baron or do we not? Yeah, I don't think it'd be a smart idea right now. I'm only level 12. Oh well. Alright then. I like how Zyra counter wards with another ward. A sapling ward, no less. That's really funny. Oh lord. How lewd! Good Oracles by Chopsy. You gotta love it. Cheering on for ward kills, that's what we should have been doing. That is one scary Ezreal. Oh, and Dark Google's trying to start a team fight. Trying to be our initiator. And Mumu just misses his grab. Good buckshot by Graves. Not buckshot, smoke grenade. Yeah. Oh, Mumu, that would have been fatal if you would have done if that would have happened. I mean, I guess we could have started the team fight there, but I don't know. Fighting there seems senseless because they can go back in that bush and they can come around and they can do whatever. It's not a good time. You're gonna have a bad time. Oh lord. Stompy Stompy. Good Cho'Gath. I like this guy. He knows what he's doing. And we were laughing at his build because look at that, he's got Ionic Spark for some reason. I have no idea why. It's really funny. 80. Oh, he's making use of Wit's End passive. I gotcha. He's abusing that passive and he's building tanky for the rest of the duration of the match. So that's a crazy Cho'Gath build. I've never seen that, but it seems to be effective, and it really helps in team fights. A whopping 282 CS from him, no less. And he's going to try to steal the blue. Oh, good lord. That's going to cost him. Or not. Okay, good. They're over here protecting their tower. Still leading in gold, leading in kills. Somehow we're only 1k behind now. I'm not sure how that happened. I guess it's just a matter of getting our shit together. So we got Baron warded. And does the Chopsy still have Oracles? No, he doesn't. Okay. But they Oracles warded, so... I like those ward skins, the little tree. That's pretty cool. He's just like, I'm a mini Maokai, I don't give a fuck. They're gonna come around and try to... I don't know what they're trying to do. I say that a lot, don't I? Alright then. Moomoo with his banshee's veil. We're all doing really good on CS. Like, I'm liking this. Except their jungler has a whole lot more than us in terms of CS, so that's why they have the gold advantage. And we don't. And, of course, more kills and stuff. But we have more towers, so I'm not entirely sure what the big issue is. Just a matter of not dying. I've got oracles. Oh, Hecarim's going to try to go in on us. But I get the stun. They get the double stun. Wukong's going to try to juke the fuck out of them. And Mumu comes in, ult again. But unfortunately, that team fight was kind of a failure. I'm trying to keep Amumu from dying, but it doesn't work. And Beastsnake, I try to come down here again and prevent him from dying, but... Oh, does he escape? Good. Good. That's a delicious-looking little Hecarim there, but we just can't do anything to it. And so they're like, okay, go get Baron now. So that's what they're gonna do. So, yeah, we know they're a Baron. Don't give a fuck. Oh, Chopsy. Oh, man, you almost died. Very nice. So, I mean, it's looking like it's game right now. It's looking like they're about to win. They've got the Baron buff. They've got everything gone. Most of us, except for everybody, are dead. Okay, now everybody's respawning. Farming that Graves. Getting those BT stacks going on. That Bloodthirster. Amumu's on fire. How fun. Remember when Sunfire Cape stacked? That was fun. That was awesome. Topical. If I get bored enough, I may just start talking about things that aren't League related. Let's see. Well, what have I done in the past few days? I think I stayed up last night, like all night, because I just couldn't sleep. I just started writing. Yeah, I'm a writer, and yeah, it's fun. I drank some coffee and got my major changed, and yeah, just that kind of thing. So yeah, my life is uneventful and boring. Kind of like what's happening right now. We're being really fucking careful because we really don't want them to take this middle tower, and we really don't want to get killed, because if they kill us now, then they've got this. They've got the match, because they can push these towers all the way to our inhib towers within that amount of time.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Oh well, we've lost that. So we're, right now, we're like, okay, let's do the CLG turtle. So we do. We're just like, hang around the tower, don't go anywhere else, while Amumu farms. And hopefully we'll win this. It's not looking that way, unfortunately. But Amumu comes up. Good ward by Soraka. Just in time. 1, 2, and 9. That's not bad at all. I'm just buying nothing but vision wards. Make sure we're not warded. I don't know what the... Oh, Ezreal had to farm. Okay. Oh man, watching last semester's Fragosity videos really makes me ashamed of how bad I used to be. Because even though I was a decent Sona, I went 0-0-15 in round 1, I can't help but just get mad at myself because I took Clarity and Flash, and Clarity's just, I don't know, it's useless. Well, it's not useless, it's just like, there's better abilities for support like Exhaust and, or even Ignite, dare I say, if you're an aggressive support. Just make sure you don't, last hit Ignite, because you know you don't want You want your AD carry to get all the kills and not you. Oh boy. Zyra being the initiator over here. The mistake they made is clumping together in a big pile of leaves or some shit, because it's like Zyra can hit them all with their ult and then Amumu can flash in and ult again. Which, by that time, they're all screwed over, so it would have been best if they would have spread out or something. That's a scary team, though. I mean, I gotta say. Especially Faerûl. He's just... this guy's so good. So insanely amazing. He's already got his Infinity Edge, Last Whisper, Phantom Dancer to abuse the Infinity Edge passive. Crazy. Zyra initiating over here, but Soraka cancels all that damage with her Wish. Wukong and Amumu, very nice combo. Oh, hell yeah. Here we go. And we're not going to let... well, we didn't want to let Hecarim escape. Dark Google takes care of Sammy Jones, very nice. Amumu gets the stun. Is it going to be enough? Oh, I should have gone up there, but oh well. Amumu got the ace, so that's all that matters. And so now that we got the ace, we decide to push the whole ever-living fuck out of mid. Just gotta wait for this minium wave. Or, you know, Amumu can tank it as well. That's fine. That's good to know. Banshee's Veil is not popped by towers, because towers don't count as magic damage, I don't think. So here we go. Pushing that mid tower.
Purple team's turret has been destroyed.
Pushing that inhibitor.
Purple team's inhibitor has been destroyed.
Good stuff. So now we're catching up again. We're still behind. 15 and 15. It's because they have more CS.
Purple team's turret has been
there
destroyed.
We go. Good tower kill. And after that, we decide to go back and buy. The gold totals on us are pretty hefty. We've all got at least 2 or 3k gold. So, it's like, you know, go back, get your stuff. I end up buying a Frozen Heart because I don't like their... they're all building Phantom Dancers and Wits Ends and that kind of thing. So I want the Frozen Heart to better defend myself and to protect everybody, and the Aegis of the Legion to both increase my damage output and decrease their damage output. Everybody else is... oh, Elixir of Brilliance on Zyra. Very cool. Got the Thornmail on Amumu to further cancel their... the damage they can do to him. The Frozen Heart actually kind of doesn't make Thornmail not as good, because Thornmail works off of countering attack speed, but I mean, it's whatever. We're still disabling as much damage as possible. At any rate, I do like this support tank build. They may have a more aggressive tank, but I don't know. That double stun, man, it's just so good. And I think that's why they banned Amumu in the World Finals. And so now we decide to try to get Baron. I've gotten Oracles. Again. Oh wait, I've had Oracles this whole time, because I've only died twice. Now if you look at the enemy team score, like it seems like they're doing a whole lot better, because we've got two people on our team that have died 5 times, but then again, we've gotten a lot of shutdowns, so the match could go either way at this point. Amumu is going to make a big mistake by trying to grab Soraka. Pro Soraka bait, actually. Somehow... oh lord. Yeah, good kill by that. Good kill by Beastsnake as well. Good stun. And we're going to try to follow it up, but unfortunately, it's just not nearly enough. Oh god, is that a dead Hecarim?
Purple team double kill.
Okay, so they got a double kill. That team fight did not turn out very well. Good kill for Wukong. Get out of there. Get out of there. Yeah, go away, Wukong. So it was a pretty much even team fight. That put them ahead about 3K. Because of the double kill. I'm not really sure how money works in that sense. Man, this frame rate. This frame rate, I tell you.
Purple team's turret has been destroyed.
It's a little strange. But the match is coming to a close. So here we go. That Sammy Jones. I've just never seen attack speed Cho'Gath ever in my life. God, it works though. It's doing some good stuff here. And that LeBlanc, man. Gotta love that LeBlanc with that DFG. Really good stuff. And that Soraka support. Also, just really good. I'm impressed, Dracor. Like, I didn't think you had it in you, but you did really good. You've improved a whole lot since we were teammates. There we go, slaying the dragon for some extra gold, putting us only 2K behind. Actually, just under that. So we're still in good shape, but at this point, gold totals isn't what really matters. It's what it's winning team fights and keeping up. It's been absolutely insane. Very nice. Graves, are you going to get the kill on the Soraka? Very good. Jeez. Trinity Force with Infinity Edge, Bloodthirster, Last Whisper. Man, that's a scary Graves. Holy shit. Well, I see what Soraka was trying to do. She was trying to go around and ward and everything. I just made a little fatal mistake. It happens to the best of us. Alright then. Very fast Baron slaying. Here we go. Now we've almost caught up, just 300 gold behind. With the lead in kills and turret kills. So we've got most of our turrets, however almost all of theirs are completely gone. So we've got the farming, we've got the inhib pushing. Shit's about to go down. Little crazy. Ionic Cho'Gath. It's kind of epic in a way, like, I don't know, it's really cool. Here we go. This frame rate is killing me. Like, I don't know. I think I need to kill some processes. At least it'll be watchable. It's definitely a watchable match. See, since I'm recording with Fraps, I've got like gigabytes and gigabytes of information just going on. Very nice ult by Mumu. I don't know if it's going to be a fatal mistake or if it's going to win us a team fight. Zyra comes in with the ult. Going to pick up a kill on Chopsy. Somebody is, Dark Google. There we go. .960 per hit from Graves. That is just obscene. All of us are hesitant to die at any time soon. We're leading in gold now. It took us a whole lot to actually get anywhere with that. There we go. Forcing Cho'Gath back a little bit. But he's just relentless in his assault. He doesn't care. He's battle casting pretty hard. Oh, here we go.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Oh, we lost the turret. It's whatever. swear these guys are running gold quints. I swear they are. I'm gonna have to verify that. How long is it till Baron? Okay, they've still got a little while on Baron. So I think our gold totals are... Yeah, everybody decides to go back and buy a little more. I wasn't entirely sure what to buy at this point. I think I just got a ruby crystal and called it a day. Oh yeah, I was actually consulting my team on what to buy. Oh, I got a Negatron cloak, that's what. Because we found out that magic resistance was going to be important against LeBlanc and their wit's end. So it was really just about counter building. Good call by LeBlanc with the Quicksilver Sash, because that's really canceling out some of Zyra's and Amumu's stuff, as well as just getting out of their ults in general. So good call, man. Jungling while they're currently turtling a little bit. Good Ezreal ult. Get a few last hits there. The purple team has blah blah blah. I like how they format it that it's green and purple, so you don't find yourself rooting for one team or the other. You just more so find yourself wondering which team is going to win, because like when you play League of Legends, you're so used to seeing red in their color that you're just not entirely... You're like, I want them to lose because they're red. Like, so I like the purple aspect of that. That's really cool. All of us are just a little bit tanky. Except for Zyra, but Zyra doesn't need to be tanky. Guardian Angel on Graves. Oh man, and Ezreal has a whopping 400 something CS. This guy's scary. Alright, I can feel it. Something's about to happen here. I'm not sure what. I think Amumu's waiting for when exactly he should ult. These guys are cleverly hiding behind the wall vision so that we can't really see what's going on. We've just got minion wave after minion wave, pushing and pushing. Pretty insane. Man, oh man. All these crits. Alright, so we decided to split push for a little bit. Which could have been heavily countered. Oh, good Zyra ult. It was a good call getting their Ezreal out of the way, but we could have used that ult more effectively, maybe. Good wish by Soraka, but it wasn't enough, because at this point, yeah. Still, I mean, well played. So we're getting their inhibitors and everything. There we go with the inhib push. We're still a little bit scared of their team, but LeBlanc goes down pretty fast. Dark Google is going to try to get out of there, but he's going to hang back for a little bit. Stick People's just tanking everything. He's just taking it like a man. He doesn't give a fuck. And we're just deciding that we're going to try to win the game right here by killing everything. Oh, we got Taric Graves. And they're like, no, come back, stun him. So they got their inhib. Pretty insane. So if Graves can get this kill on Cho'Gath, we got almost nothing to worry about. And there's the stun on Chopsy. And we're like, just don't worry about it, just attack the inhib, and there we go. So that was game. Alright, good match. I'm not exactly sure what to say about it, because the opposing team, Moe's team, did very, very well. Like, you guys did amazingly. We were legitimately scared shitless when we saw your team play against Bastard Pirates team. But it's all good. I mean, good game, well played, and I guess I'll see you guys next time.